This first piece we're going to play is called West Wings. What is it? Wrong set, sorry. Come back at 9 o'clock, we'll play it for you. This is a tune that was written by Quincy Jones and performed by the Count Basie Orchestra way back in the 50s. And then it was redone with Quincy Jones and Sam Inestico later for a wonderful album that they did together in the 2000s, early, I think it was about 2000. This is called Belly Roll. It's going to feature many soloists. We hope you enjoy Belly Roll.
Thank you.
Association for at least 5 years with a wonderful musician, composer, music director of the Pancho Sanchez Latin Jazz Band. He composes for TV and film. He composes for Disney TV. plays in a big fat band. He plays trombone, and he's a wonderful composer, and he's done so many beautiful works for us. And this is maybe the most beautiful. This is a reprise of a commission we did with him about 3 years ago. This is called Danzone para mi tierra. Friend Edgardo.
How is everybody doing? Are these kids great or what? Well, they are your kids, you should say yes. Well, a while back when Francisco wrote this piece, he asked me to do something for it, and it was so perfect that I said, I don't think I can add much to it, except that I could write some lyrics in the front, a nice poem, because he was relating the communion for many, many, many years, decades between Mexico and Cuba and the Caribbean and the music in many, many different ways. Most of you may know that Mr. Pérez Prado, arguably the creator of a mambo, became very, very popular in Mexico before actually making it here in the United States. And that's an example of many, many styles of music that they go from the Caribbean to Mexico to make it, and then of course, as you know, there is a lot of Mexicans in the world. Raise up your hand if you're Mexicano. ¿Dónde están los Mexicanos? Muy pocos Mexicanos. Okay, we gotta bring down the tuition of the school there at Northgate. We gotta... Familia, come on. Okay. All right. This is a poem that I wrote for this, and it's called Danzón de mi Tierra. De Cuba salen raíces de mi tierra mexicana, como flechas musicales de ritmo y canto, que unen dos tierras hermanas, Veracruz y su son jarocho, zapateado, rumba de La Habana, ramas del mismo tronco, sangre en común que se derrama. Un ritmo son del Caribe, reclama con gritos de victoria, con tormentas, luego la calma. Que esta tradición no ha muerto y lleva a África en el alma. Danzón para mi tierra.
Francisco did. I heard on one of the albums he wrote some music for and loved it and asked him to arrange it for us, and he did. We got it a month ago, maybe 5 weeks ago, and we're going to feature Edgardo on this. This is Wayne Shorter's Yes or No.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
That piece, thank you, was written by Jerry Dodgen, who was the one of the saxophone players in the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Orchestra back in the 70s. And he wrote that beautiful piece. Very challenging, and we took it on, and I'm so proud of these guys for making that happen. Beautiful. Beautiful. J.R. Zaha on the piano. Marcello Pajucasco on the alto saxophone. Bryce Hayashi on flugelhorn. Andy McKinney on trombone. Kirby Galbraith on bass trombone. And Dennis Lipschitz on the baritone sax. Yeah! We've got one more for you. This is from Francisco Torres. This is our commission from Francisco this year called Gate 68. I'll tell you before we Will Ortiz on baritone sax. Dennis Lipschitz on baritone sax. Kirby Galbraith on trombone. Artem Rossi on trumpet. John Wake on trumpet calls. Michael Arnold on the drums. Steffi Guerrero on timbales. Edgardo Cambone's got something up his sleeve, too. Gate 68.
Now, before we take off with this last one, I want to teach you a little chant, okay? Because in the middle of this song, there's going to be a section. And in that section, I expect to have full participation from the audience today. Because these guys deserve it. They won 5 times that competition, you know? Amazing. And it didn't cost me 1 penny. It didn't cost me anything. Let's see if you can repeat this. Ibarago. Agomo. Yubara. Can you remember that? Very easy, right? 3 words. Ibarago. Agomo. Yubara. Ibarago. Agomo. Yubara. This is the last song, and this is a chant from Yoruba land. Yoruba land is the land that it was many, many years back on the area that we know as Nigeria, the west coast of Africa. The majority of the slaves that came to this country and to Cuba and the Caribbean came from that area. And I just want to mention to you that if it wouldn't be for that painful transculturalization, if that word exists, if it doesn't exist, you can, you know, put it in your book and give you credit for it. All this music wouldn't be existing. Jazz, Afro-Cuban music, pop. When you hear a band going with reggaeton going booch papu papu papu, that's traceable to West Africa. So I want to dedicate this chant, which is a Yoruba chant, in closing to a Yoruba deity who is Elegwa or Elegba, who opens and closes the path for all mankind. It doesn't really matter if you believe in my religion or I believe in yours. We can sing something positive about this so you all get home today safely. We all do. Thank you. Santo Mayor, cabeza de los demás. El Ecuador, oye. Ecuador, papá. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
can sing. Let's see if you can clap now. That's right. I like it.
Appreciate it.